Recently, I was driving through downtown Chicago, when to the left of me, I noticed I was driving past mHUB. If you don't know mHUB, it's what they call an innovation center, where they gather investors, entrepreneurs, and manufacturers with the latest technology, training, and networking to build a robust business economy right here in the Midwest. I got a chance to sit down with Quinn Campbell, who's a design and fabrication specialist, to discuss this exciting venture. So, Quinn.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit about yourself and what you do here at mHUB.
I'm Quinn Campbell. I'm one of the shop staff here. I like to refer to myself as the shop Sherpa, spiritual guide to the shop. I help people create their prototypes, figure out better ways of fabricating their designs, potential flaws for down the road when they're actually going into production. But my number one job here is safety and training to make sure that members are using tools appropriately and in a safe manner.
When I first found out about mHUB Insider, which is where you do your videos on YouTube, my initial thought was you're a makerspace. But quickly, I realized you weren't.
No, yeah.
Could you tell me the difference between what you do here and what a makerspace does?
So mHUB is not, as you said, a makerspace at all. We are a space for makers, though. So the purpose and point of mHUB is to help entrepreneurs and startups actually take a product to market rather than just, it's the two steps above a hobbyist, essentially. So there are some hobbyists in the space, but it is specifically for people that are building a product to create a company, to grow the economy, to build a business around whatever their idea might have been. For mHUB, I mean, like, we're staffed. I have a number of regularly scheduled help sessions every week, all the shop staff does. We have a marketing department, we have a mentor network. So outside of the shop, we want your business to succeed and grow, and we've developed the pipelines to help you go from, here's my idea, here's my MVP, here's the beginning of production, and building the marketing and the sales channels and all the other things that you don't know you need to know, all in one building. So it's also kind of the ethos of what's really nice about having this shop is you have all of these different pieces of equipment right next to each other, and you don't have to go from one guy to prototype to another guy to prototype. You can just walk to the other side of the building and do it yourself.
You have a lot of machinery here.
Yes, we do.
Obviously, you're very well funded. You have pretty much everything you need to do some prototyping and small manufacturing. Mm-hmm. What is it about the Tormach that add to that?
The area that we can see everything, but everything along the row of this building is the stuff that is under my direct training purview. And the Tormach is definitely the area that I kind of hit the hardest when I first started. They're fundamental in that you are going to start with a CNC model, CNC object for a lot of different things, from vacuum forming, to final production, to making tools to be able to do other things. It's just a really nice jumping off point to get other things done, because you always need one tool to build another tool. And the lovely thing about the Tormach, and I say this all the time, is it's just really easy to use. The control system on it is amazing, in that I can take pretty much any Joe Schmo and teach him how to use a piece of CNC equipment, which honestly is scary to somebody that's never touched a machine tool before, and there can get, I like to brag, and don't know if it's true, but I'd like to find, I can take anybody that's moderately intelligent and train them to do CAM and CNC in about a week. There's a number of members that we've done that for. So it's just really nice because it's a low lift to get them using the equipment.
You've been here 5 years, and you've been, have you had these Tormach machines the whole time? Added on?
So, that P right behind me was the very first one. It was the only one that we had when I first started. Actually used to sit right here. This area has moved around a bunch. And then we got some budget to be able to buy two new pieces of equipment. So we bought the 15L and the M, and then another benefactor actually donated their old P to us.
Oh,
so
great.
It's definitely expanded and rolled. And the benefit of having that is we have some super, what I like to call super users. They have a little bit more access than other people. But it allows me to upgrade the machines and not take one offline and really affect somebody else's workflow, because we now have so much equipment.
Okay. sometimes users crash machines. Has anyone crashed one of the Tormachs?
I really hate that you asked that question because the answer is no.
Oh, really?
Well, mills, no.
Yes.
Lathe, slightly, and it probably was me. But now that you asked that, I'm sure someone's going to crash it next week.
Sorry.
I didn't want to teach you. Yeah. One of the benefits, though, that I like about Tormachs is I could probably fix it with a hammer or, you know, sub $1,000 worth of parts. And that's manageable. That's not too bad of an issue. I do all the maintenance myself. I'm currently in the middle of maintaining the M and doing some upgrades there. So you'll be seeing that video come soon. But no, that's, yeah, no one's really damaged real bad. But actually, to the lathe thing, in the aviation industry, it's said that planes are built to fly and helicopters are built to fly apart. I like to tell people the lathes are, mills are built to machine, lathes are built to crash. There's just so many, it's very tight space. But yeah.
So what is the 15L lathe added to the program?
We didn't have a lathe before. We have a little tiny baby plastic lathe, so it actually added a lathe with some capability. You would have seen in another mHUB Inside video, our lathe parks puller catch object. Yeah. Because I looked around the internet and I didn't see anybody else doing it. I've been thinking for a really long time, how can I mechanize this with, we have the little M box, IO code box, but I found it easier just to do a physical mechanical one. It allows for a decent, like, actual pass-through. So I can hit go and then walk away and have 50 or 100 parts, depending on the size of the stock and the size of the part. It just adds more capability.
So Tormach's really big in education. Mm-hmm. And you are educating entrepreneurs. Mm-hmm. And since you're in a community, do you have a chance to educate people within the community, high schoolers, college students?
Yeah, so actually, we had 6 shop interns this summer, and one of them was college, the rest were high school, and they were all super excited to learn. That they were like, yeah, I want to learn how to use this. And I taught 4 of them at the same time, how to mill stuff. And the other one, one of the benefits of the lathe is if you're doing very simple, small things, you can just use it manually. And I was like, yeah, just go in there and make some chips, it's fine. And they took it far enough to start doing conversational. And made themselves some chess pieces just by kind of futzing around with it for a day. So it's nice enough that you can learn how to do it on your own without much guidance. They did the online training, so they had that nice layout of what the steps should be, but I didn't even really guide them.
What is it about Chicago that is an advantage for this type of facility?
So Chicago is central to the Midwest. We have a lot of connection to the sprawling manufacturing industry that is in the Midwest and in smaller towns and just a little bit of everywhere. We're part of the TMA, so with that, there's a huge connection, and we're the central hub, mHUB, the hub of manufacturing, and it really helps to be central to all of the different manufacturing techniques that you might need to get your product to market.
Your mHUB Insider is about a year old now, right?
About a year, yeah.
What was the impetus for that?
So it had actually been something that I thought would have a good value for mHUB. One, as a potential training site. Two, is just showing us as an interesting marketing, which is kind of how you found us. It just has a lot of different avenues of value. It had been something that I wanted to do, I just didn't personally have time. And we got some awesome new marketing people around that time. Kim, who was on the videos. And she greenlit it and we got it rolling. And I feel like it's been a pretty decent value for us.
What do you love about your job that gets you excited every single day to come into work?
I really dig that it's always something new. It's always a different, weird problem to solve. So as I said, my background is solving problems with products, industrial design. All of the members are solving some kind of problem. And working here, while I don't work on those people's projects for them, I definitely get to advise. So it's always a different little problem that I get to solve. And it just satisfies that little nugget in my head that's like, hey, solve a problem. I don't care what the problem is. Just give me a new one to solve and move on to the next cool thing. I also get to play with a lot of fun toys and do personal projects, which is always just a side benefit.
You've got all the toys.
Yeah,
here.
We have all the toys. And I get to do YouTube, which is pretty wicked.
Yeah. If you haven't seen the mHUB Inside YouTube channel, click this link. If you like what you see, subscribe and hit their bell icon. From our Tormach family to yours, be safe and happy milling.